Hello everyone. Today we are going to discuss about elasticity of demand. Elasticity of demand is having a very important aspect. It's a very important aspect in economic theory. So you know that demand will be changing. Demand will be changing most of the time because of the price. It may be person to person, place to place, or various transactions. So there will be demand. The changes of demand, we can just measure it in this elasticity of demand. This elasticity, the word has borrowed from the physics. One variable to another variable, sometimes you'll find the difference. Changes you'll find. That changes will be measuring in this elasticity of demand. Why the changes? Because of one variable. The second variable is getting affected, that elasticity which we are going to discuss in this elasticity of demand. You know that most of the time to particular products, say product A, product B. Product A will not get affected because of the price or any kind of changes. For example, product A, you can take rice, dal, vegetables, milk, all these things. Though the price is increasing or decreasing, it doesn't make any difference. People will buy it. So product A. And product B will make lot of difference. What is this product B means? Suppose say you can take electronic items like cell phones, TV, refrigerator, vehicles, two-wheeler or four-wheeler, or ACs. All these things makes difference because of the price increase or decreasing. If it is increasing, people will buy less. If it is decreasing, they'll buy more. So this is elasticity also, you can say. Now how we can define this elasticity of demand? I'll give you a small definition here. So elasticity of demand is generally defined as the responsiveness or sensitiveness of demand to a given change in the price of product. The change in the price of product which will make difference in the demand. That is, we call it as in simple words, elasticity of demand. You can see that types of elasticity of demand. Different types of elasticity of demand are there. One is price elasticity of demand, income elasticity of demand, cross elasticity of demand, advertising elasticity of demand. So this is price of elasticity of demand. We'll discuss in depth. And the second, third, fourth are quite easy to understand. First one is that price elasticity of demand. So this we have to discuss in depth. What is this price elasticity of demand? When there is a change in the price of one product, another product. So that makes the difference in our product. Say product A is changing price. Our product is product B. So product A is increasing. Our product B will have more demand. If product A price is decreasing, then our product price will, demand will be less because the price is decreasing. So that is where price of elasticity is talking about the price only. Where the price is increasing, then demand will be decreasing. Where the price is decreasing, demand will increase it. Based on this, we are going to discuss price elasticity of demand. Here, let me tell you a small definition of price elasticity of demand. Price elasticity of demand is the responsiveness of quantity demanded of a product to a given change of price. The responsiveness of quantity demanded. The demand will be changing because of the price only. So that you can measure it through a small formula. So that is, price elasticity of demand is equal to proportionate change in the quantity of demand product by what is the quantity of demand? The quantity of demand is changing of product A divided by proportionate change in the price of B. So whenever there is a change in the price, that makes the difference in the quantity of the demand. This is price elasticity of demand, basic concept of price elasticity of demand. Now this price elasticity of demand, we can measure it through formula. This formula, we can just show it like this, EDP. EDP means elasticity of demand of price. P is price. ED is elasticity of demand. That is equal to Q2 minus Q1 by Q1 divided by P2 minus P1 by P1. Q1 means the quantity before changing the price. Quantity before changing the price. Before change of price. Q2 is after changing the price. So Q1 is before changing the price demand, Q2 is after changing the price of the demand, the quantity. Q2 minus Q1 by Q1 divided by P2 minus P1 by P1. P means price. In the same way, P1 means first price before changing the price. P2 is after changing the price. So P2 minus P1 by P1. That's it, you can get the price elasticity of demand. Now we'll be discussing price elasticity of demand in depth. Price elasticity of demand has 5 types that we are going to discuss. Now we'll discuss about 5 types of price elasticity of demand. 5 types. It's very easy to understand, just focus 5 minutes, you can understand easily. So the first one is that types of price elasticity of demand. First one is perfectly elastic demand. In perfectly elastic demand, quantity will be always changing, where the price is constant. There's no change in the price, but still quantity will be changing. So in that case, we say it as a perfectly elastic demand. You can observe through a diagram here, through a map. So here, x-axis we are taking quantity, y-axis price we are taking. Now you can see demand curve. Demand is horizontal. It's not changing at all. The price is stable. The price is stable, no change at all. But quantity is changing here. See Q1, Q2, Q3 means different types of quantity. Quantity is varying or changing, though there is no change in the price. Price is stable, but still quantity is changing. When it is possible, to few commodities, in few situations it happens, though the price is stable. Say for example, seasonal products, you can take the best example. Especially in summer season, you'll have more demand for the air coolers, ACs, ice cream products and all items. And in winter, though the price is not changing, price is same as it is. When summer comes, there will be lot of demand for those products, like just now as I told you, air coolers and ACs, ice creams and all cool items. When it comes to winter, same products demand will be less. Price is not changing, same. In the same way, winter you can take. Especially for the woolen clothes and warm items, demand will be more. When it comes to winter, summer, that is decreasing. So like, though the price is not changing, demand will be varying because of the fashion, because of the season, because of the requirement, because of change in the technology, whatever it may be, price is stable, but demand will be always changing. That is perfectly elastic demand. Are you getting this? Yeah. Next we'll go for perfectly inelastic, quite opposite to this. That is why we say it as inelastic. Price inelastic demand. Here what happened, quite opposite to this, price is changing. Price is changing, increasing or decreasing, but demand is same. There is no change in the demand. Demand is as it is. Through a diagram we can see OX demand, OY price we have taken. Here demand is same, stable. In the previous one, price was stable. Now yes, demand is stable, but price is changing. P1, P2, P3, like price is changing, though demand is same. Demand is not changing, though the price is changing. What are the products? What is the situation? What is the best example which you can take for this? Daily usage commodities. You can think daily usage commodities like vegetables or fruits, eatable any kind of items, petrol, all these things, whatever may be the changes in the price, demand will be there always. Demand will be stable. No changes in the demand. You want to increase the price? Yes, you can increase. We want to increase, we may decrease. But we use it in the same way. Another example also you can take, salt. When the price is increasing, do you consume more? No. When the price is decreasing, do you consume less? No. general items which we cannot avoid. These commodities, these products will come under this perfectly elastic demand. What is perfectly elastic demand? Though the price is changing, increasing or decreasing, that doesn't make any difference in the demand of the commodity or demand of the product. Demand will be as it is. Now third one will come, relatively elastic demand. In relative elastic demand, a small change in the price will make a lot of difference in the demand. A small change in the price. We can see through this diagram, here we're taking price and quantity. OY is price, OX is quantity. Now price is P1. When price is P1, so demand is Q1. When price is decreasing a little bit, it's decreasing a little bit, so that is changing in the demand a lot. So this is the change in the demand. Small change in the price, decreasing the price, that is increasing the demand a lot. Maybe probably this is 10%. We have decreased. If you see this, it may be 50% increase in the demand. For such products, it happens where there is a lot of demand, there is a lot of consumption. A little bit change also, people will go and buy. The best example which you can take, gold. Gold rate is increasing a little bit. People will go and buy in the form of biscuits and they keep it in the locker and all these things happens. So because of small change, slight change in the price. So this is, we say, a relatively elastic demand. Next, fourth, relatively inelastic, opposite to this. Lot of change in the price, but demand will be only very less. Change in the price is a lot, but proportionate demand, if you see, it will be very less. So that we call it as relatively inelastic demand. See it through the diagram. Here, price is on the OY axis, quantity OX axis. First price is P1. When P1 is the price, quantity was Q1. When we have decreased the price, so this is what we have decreased. P2. Quantity is Q2. But how much it is increased the quantity? Quantity is very less. Where the price has decreased a lot, but quantity is very less increased. People are not much interested. So in such cases, we say it is relative inelastic demand. And fourth one is unilateral elasticity of demand. In unilateral elasticity of demand, price is increasing 50%, 50% demand will be increasing. Both are equal. No ups and downs. In the previous first four elasticity of demand, price elasticity of demand, there's a lot of changes. But now here, equivalent. 10% increased price, 10% increase in the demand. See the diagram? So here, when price is P1, quantity is Q1. Price is P2, quantity is P2. So if you see, this is same, proportionate if you see. Whatever is decreased, same thing is increased the demand. So this we call as unilateral elasticity of demand. Demand curve also you can observe here. So it's equal, perfect demand curve you can find in the last one. And the other elasticity of demand, total elasticity of demand are four. Price elasticity of demand and three more. Three more we'll be discussing now. In elasticity of demand, we have seen the price elasticity of demand. And the second elasticity of demand is income elasticity of demand. The name itself is saying very clearly income elasticity of demand. Elasticity of demand because of income. If income is changing, definitely the demand will be more. Income is decreasing, demand will be less. So this is elasticity of demand through the income. The best example which you can take, once upon a time, IT sector, they were giving a lot of salaries, lot of packages. So due to the more salaries, there was a boom in the real estate field. And after that, after a certain period, IT sector has come down. Automatically, you know that real estate also has come down. So this is the impact of income. So we'll see this through a small formula. Income elasticity of demand, EDI. ED means elasticity of demand. I is income. So the formula is proportionate change in the quantity demanded for product A, proportionate change in the quantity demand of product A divided by proportionate change in the income. Whatever we change in the income, that makes the difference of the product A demand. So that we can show through observation. EDI is equal to Q2 minus Q1 by Q1, I2 minus I1 by I1. EDI means elasticity of demand of income. Q1, quantity before changes in the income. Q2, quantity or demand of the quantity after changing the income. Now I1 is income, first income. I2 is second income, means second time after changing in the income. So this makes difference in the quantity. This is about the income elasticity of demand. And the third one is cross elasticity of demand. Cross elasticity of demand says that one product price is increasing or decreasing, that makes difference of the demand of another product. One product price is increasing, then our product will be, whenever it is increasing, our product demand will be more. If they are decreasing the price, then our product demand will become down. So whatever changes, it happens relatively near to the product of particular product or particular price, that makes difference in another product also. So that you can show it through a formula. EDC, elasticity of demand. C means cross elasticity of demand. Cross means one product, another product, cross. Proportionate change in the quantity demanded for product A. Proportionate change in the quantity demanded for product A. This changes, it comes because of proportionate change in the price of product A. Change in the product A. So because of this price, so there is a quantity of demand is changing in the product B, another product. So that you can show through formula like abbreviation EDC, elasticity of demand of cross elasticity of demand is equal to BQ2 minus BQ1. B means product B. Changes in the quantity of the demand of product B before changes BQ1, after changes BQ2 divided by BQ1, old price divided by AP2 minus AP1 by AP1. Price of product A before changes AP1. Price of product A after changes, after price. So that divided by AP1. So like we can find out the second one, cross elasticity of demand. And last one is advertising elasticity of demand. So this advertising elasticity of demand is because of advertisement. Whenever you find advertising is more, awareness will be there for the product by the consumer, then there will be demand. No advertisement, no awareness, no knowledge to the consumers, then automatically demand will be less. Based on advertisement, demand will be increasing or decreasing. This is saying by the advertising elasticity of demand. That we can show through a formula. EDA, elasticity of demand because of advertisement. A means advertisement. Proportionate change in the quantity of product X. Demand of the product X by proportionate change in advertising cost. Advertising cost is increasing, demand also will increase. Demand will increase, advertisement cost is increasing, demand also will increase. And very rarely it happens that advertising is not affecting on the consumer's behavior. It is very rare case, generally it happens. Now the same thing formula we can show it through abbreviation. EDA is equal to Q2 minus Q1 by Q1 by A2 minus A1 by A1. Q1 is quantity before changes in the advertisement, before spending for the advertisement. Q2 is quantity changes after advertisement. A1, advertisement before advertisement cost, and A2 is after advertisement. Like we can find out the variation. So the difference between the price and the difference between the demand, everything through elasticity of demand we can find out. Four types of elasticity of demand we have discussed. Let me give you a recap. First one is price elasticity of demand. Because of the price changes in the price variations. That makes difference in the demand. Price elasticity of demand, we have discussed 5 types of price elasticity demand. Price elasticity, that's over. Second one is here, income elasticity of demand. Through the income is increasing or decreasing, that makes the difference in the demand. And third one is cross elasticity of demand. One product is going to affect because of the price of another product. And last one, advertising elasticity of demand. Because of advertising, the demand will be increasing or decreasing through the awareness. So like elasticity of demand, we have discussed entirely. This is a very important concept. Definitely one question you can expect in the final exam. This was my favorite topic when I was student. And every time we used to get, I have done my intermediate in like CEC, BCom, MCom. Every year, first year, intermediate CEC, BCom first year, and MCom first year. Every time I used to score good marks because of one concept of this only. So hope you got a very good understanding about elasticity of demand. Please recap it. After hearing this lecture, immediately take any book, start referring. It will be more clear for you. If possible, prepare the notes also. So stay connected with me for more talks. So wish you good luck. Take care.